It's the eye in the sky that's both punisher and protector. Red light cameras are all over Tampa Bay, and the legal fight surrounding them is about to ramp up again.
New tonight in our new Full Circle report, ABC Action News anchor Paul Legrone examines all sides. Are the cameras moneymakers or lifesavers?
They see the collision no one else saw coming. Red light cameras.
The impact force is even worse.
They get the credit.
A person who gets that citation is going to think twice when they're going through that intersection again.
And the blame.
The tickets are, you know, well over $150. You're making people more paranoid as drivers.
I'm so happy to be here.
For Elijah Alexander, the red light camera may not have stopped the driver who nearly killed him.
I gotta die.
But it does provide proof of a growing problem. A recent AAA study found that deaths caused by drivers running red lights hit a 10-year high in 2017. And Florida accounted for 10% of all fatal red light crashes in 2017. Red light cameras are positioned at more than 100 intersections throughout Tampa Bay, more than 500 throughout the state. Still, there are questions about whether red light cameras are effective. A recent state report found that statewide, intersections with red light cameras saw a 15% increase in crashes after the cameras were installed. Rear-end crashes went up 12%, and the number of red light runners stayed the same. There's also a question of accuracy.
Is it possible for the camera to get it wrong?
There are mistakes that can be had, and because of either blurriness or something being illegible in the video or just a slight mistake based on, you know, one digit or one character in a license plate, a citation can be issued incorrectly.
And now there's a bill moving up the agenda in Tallahassee that would ban red light cameras in Florida. But despite all this, Tampa and Clearwater just renewed their contracts with red light camera companies.
Do red light cameras save lives?
I think they do.
Clearwater Police Chief Daniel Slaughter believes red light cameras hold drivers accountable.
And every time they go through that intersection after paying that fine, they're going to say, this is the place I got the red light ticket.
The critics say that these are money grabs, that they're cash cows for a city.
You know, I understand the criticism. The system we've set up in Clearwater, the police department doesn't benefit from the financial fines that come in. It goes straight to the city general fund.
But it's not just the money that local governments are making off of red light cameras. It's also the campaign cash that the companies selling these cameras are giving out to the very elected leaders who have a big say in where and how the cameras are used.
We followed the money. Campaign finance records show that American Traffic Solutions, the biggest red light vendor in the state, has given nearly $2 million to political candidates in both parties since 2008. The company also contributed $500 to former Tampa City Councilman Mike Suarez and Harry Cohen and current Councilman Charlie Miranda. And all three voted in favor of renewing the company's contract with the city for five more years. Suarez told us the contribution had no influence on his vote, and he supports the cameras because he believes they keep drivers safe. American Traffic Solutions also donated $1,000, the maximum under state law, to Sheriff Chad Chronister, who's in charge of administering Hillsborough's red light camera contract. The sheriff told us, quote, we raised over $1 million and people from all walks of life donated, and the campaign followed every Florida law in regards to campaign finance, disclosures, and disclaimers.
But to get, you know, knocked over by a ticket like this, where, you know, they don't forgive it and throw it out, that could really do damage.
Tampa City Councilman Guido Maniscalco did not take money from red light camera companies, and he voted twice against them. But he doesn't believe his colleagues are influenced by campaign contributions.
So I think they're honest people, all of them, and I don't think it would have made a difference.
However, he does question the company's motive behind the contributions.
Why make contributions if this is about safety?
The heart of this argument is this about safety or is it about money?
It's about money.
We reached out to American Traffic Solutions. They did not respond to our request for comment.
201.
But in the city of Lakeland,
we have now the technology to be able to prevent the crash.
Traffic manager Angelo Rao is working on new technology that could neutralize the debate over red light cameras.
We delay the green so that a crash doesn't occur.
He's testing out sensors that can detect if a driver is not going to stop in time, keeping the light red for everyone.
If the computer calculated a problem, it would say, no, 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 Paul, you're going to wait 2 seconds. We're going to delay your green by 2 seconds. You don't even get involved in the intersection, and that's where we save lives.
The sensors are also collecting data on red light running. And no matter how you feel about cameras, the results are disturbing.
What surprised me was that at one intersection, over a six-month average period, we had 48 average per day at this one intersection running the red light after the green light went on. That surprised me.
The city of Lakeland is still using red light cameras to catch red light runners. Right now, those sensors are just being tested out. The state still needs to approve them. Meanwhile, Sheriff Chad Cronister telling us that after reviewing all the latest data, he thinks the cameras have become just another sort of ticket tax, as he says, on motorists. And he says the sheriff's office will be reviewing these issues to determine if Hillsborough County will renew the red light camera contract. To see their full statements, head to our Full Circle section on abcactionnews.com. Plus, we've made an interactive map there of all the red light cameras throughout Tampa Bay so you can see where they are. Paul LeGrone, ABC Action News.